studies. Tonight's concert, in addition to all the concerts this spring, is very special, as there haven't been spring concerts in this auditorium since May of 2019. The COVID-19 pandemic had a huge impact on our music department, but here we are again for a night celebrating student achievement in the arts. Please allow me a minute to thank a few important people and groups before we begin. First, Principal Newman, for his unwavering support of art and music at Brooklyn Tech. The Parent Association and Alumni Foundation for their generous financial support. The safety agents and deans that help make these concerts and events possible to host. Ms. Revy and Mr. Tassopoulos for assisting with each concert. Mr. Isaacson, head of stage works and everything that happens here behind the scenes. Give it up for Mr. Isaacson. Thank you. Mr. Ron McIntyre, our lighting designer and auditorium operations manager and media specialist. Thank you, Mr. McIntyre. A new member of the tech community, Mr. Adam Reisch, our new sound engineer working the board in the back. Thank you, Adam, for being here. Our media students that capture and immortalize these concerts for everyone to enjoy in the future. Everyone in the audience who came out on a humid and possibly very rainy night, thank you for being here. And last but not least, our band director, Mr. Withers. And just a note about Mr. Withers. When I realized last spring that I would have to find a new band director for this year, I was just a bit worried, to say the least. Luckily, we found Mr. Withers, or he found his way back, because he is a Tech alum. He is the quintessential band teacher. He gives up enormous amounts of free time during the day, after school, and on weekends. He has endless patience and understanding. He's rigorous, yet empathetic. And as a former band student myself, he's exactly what we needed here at Tech. So thank you, Mr. Withers, for all that you do. Please give it up for Mr. Withers. And just a quick reminder, please silence all electronic devices. If possible, wait for intermission to leave the auditorium. And if you do have to leave, please shut the door behind you very gently. Thank you. Enjoy the show.
Thank you. for the Jazz Quintet, please. Quintet plus one. So that is a group of seniors who sort of just came together on their own. They had a common lunch period, and they came to my room and just started jamming, and then all of a sudden, they formed a band. And so that was completely student-directed. They picked their own music, they worked out the arrangements, and that was all them. So I want to make sure that I give them the credit for all the hard work that they did. And so during those rehearsals, a conversation came up where we were talking about the jazz band, and the jazz band in this school is the, it is considered the most advanced wind class in the building. And the jazz band is, they are amazing musicians. And when I met them, they were incredible technical musicians, and we were talking about the world of jazz and improvisation. And we decided in our quintet rehearsals, quintet plus one rehearsals, that there needed to just be a bridge to get from the beginning musician to jazz band. In a way that introduces them to the style, the different styles of jazz, the technique, and the theory behind improvisation. So the next group that's coming up is about to make their complete debut because we created a junior jazz band, and they met after school, and this is where they really got into the beginning, the introductory rudiments of jazz, and then they sort of took off from there. So, without further ado, I'm going to present to you the Junior Jazz Band for the very first time.
Thank you.
In this group, and at this time, I'm gonna ask one of them to come to the stage and direct the next piece. So, I bring to the stage, Arthur Gault. Thank you so much. And again, Junior Jazz Band. So I just wanted to one more time shout out the wonderful job that the seniors have done, the co-presidents of the Junior Jazz Band. I can't see Micah, where are you? Micah Fisher, come to the stage. There you are, okay. All right, and then Micah and Arthur really are the ones who put together the quintet plus one, and these guys really, a wonderful job. Please give them a round of applause. One of the beautiful things about our conversations is we talked about how you guys didn't get a couple of years of performances because of everything that happened. And one of the things that Micah said to me that really struck with me, he said, we wanted to do something that created a legacy in this building. And so I think you have done a great job. And so everyone who is watching us wants to be a part of this and wants to take over for you guys. So thank you for setting such a great start to this. You can if you want to get out. All right. And next up, we're going to bring up the junior band. Thank you.
Thank you.
So just to give a little context on their necessities, at the beginning of this semester, I gave the seniors an opportunity to vote for the piece that they've played in their time here in high school, that they played, that they enjoyed the most, and that was the piece that they chose, although it was a very close close vote, and some people were very upset about that. But nonetheless, that was one of their favorites from their high school career, so that was Bare Necessities. We're going to now go on to another piece called Fantasy in a Japanese Folk Song. It will involve Eric playing the piano, our part on the piano. Arthur has moved over to the vibes. I have a guest from my junior band, Nelson, playing percussion in this band as well. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
too. The seniors voted for, again, their song that they, their favorite song that they played. They voted for this song, and they've been tormenting me with it ever since. So, with that said, we bring you The Chicken.
Thank you. and everyone. Can we get another amazing round of applause for this? Mr. Withers has an unmatched passion for inspiring confidence in his students. I remember in the beginning of the year, when everyone was terrified to improvise, Mr. Withers made us perform these one-note solos that helped us break out of our shells and gave us the confidence we needed to aspire to be greater. This one note turned into five notes, which later turned into teaching about the complexities of chord changes and improvising over pieces. His unique teaching style, his very corny jokes, his dedication to embracing and learning from all our strengths and weaknesses, and his silent acts, such as spending his own time to make everyone personalized sheet music with chord tones, shows how much he cares about giving each and every one of us the opportunity to succeed. I would never be the musician I am today without Mr. Withers, and I thank you for always making the class enjoyable and inspiring me to reach further than I ever thought I was capable.
Mr. Withers let me play trumpet, piano, even percussion. I played in the concert band, the jazz band, the quintet, and I got to conduct in the junior jazz band. Not only has Mr. Withers never said no to one of my requests, he's pushed me even further. With every opportunity that Mr. Withers gave me, alongside his mentoring and teaching, he's led me to grow as a musician. I cannot thank him enough for the knowledge and skill that I've gained during this year. Coming back from an almost two-year break from the music program at Tech, as a brand new band director, Mr. Withers has done an incredible job. So not only am I thanking Mr. Withers for his hard work in rebuilding this program and mentoring me, I'm thanking him for an incredible senior year. I could not have asked for anything more. Thank you, Mr. Withers.
The stereotype is that band kids are loud, obnoxious, annoying, and don't stop talking about band ever. And throughout this year, as jazz band, we've had moments where we fit into the stereotype perfectly. We put people into inflatable chicken suits and had them parade around the entire band room playing saxophone. We tried to insert random percussion instruments into songs that they really don't belong in. And we've been insanely loud and obnoxious. I'm talking so loud that people four floors below the band room have complained that they can hear us and that we're too loud. But despite all of our craziness, we've grown together so much, both as musicians and as a community, and of course we couldn't have done it without Mr. Withers. I came into this year not knowing what to expect at all. After 2 years of no music at Tech, we had a new band director, but this turned out to be the best year I've ever had. Starting from our very first jazz band class, you've made your passion for music and teaching very clear. You've made so many people fall in love with music all over again by making the band room a welcoming and fun environment for everyone. Your dedication to making us leave each lesson as better musicians made fifth period my favorite class of the day, and each day I began to count down the hours to when I could finally be up in the band room again. And your dedication to help us improve as musicians didn't stop in class. When I expressed interest in playing for the musical and there was no guitar part, you handed me a bass and said, "You can learn to play this in 2 months, right?" You took the time and had the patience to help me learn a completely different instrument and got me to a level of performance on both bass and guitar that I could have never imagined myself to be at, especially not over such a short period of time. You've always given us the freedom to create new music and dedicated countless hours to growing the music department at Tech. You've given me the opportunity to both help form the jazz quintet, to help lead junior jazz band, and to conduct in front of an audience, which is something I would have never believed I would have been able to do at the end of this year. And throughout this time, you've truly made band a second home to me. You've been with me for all the ups and downs of this entire year. From crying in the orchestra pit after getting rejected from my dream college half an hour before playing the Friday night show of the musical, to my constant chicken puns and jokes, and all the moments in between, you were always there for me with anything I might need, whether that be some words of encouragement, or a snarky joke to cheer me up, or even just a hug. When I think of what I'm going to miss most from high school, band will easily be the first thing that comes to mind, and I owe that to your passion. Thank you for being an amazing teacher. Thank you for making my senior year unforgettable. Thank you for helping me grow as a musician. And most importantly, thank you for helping me grow as a person. I'll miss you so much.
I'm the one who wants to thank all of you guys. I want to thank all of the parents and the friends and family who have supported us coming back this year. It was scary, especially with everything going on with COVID. But you guys has made this year an amazing year for me. And I make no secret about it. This right here has been my dream job since I was 14 years old. Please do not do the math. So to all of the musicians, the administrators, the team, the Miss Revy, Mr. T, Mr. I, Mr. Mac, Stageworks, Mr. Cliff, to everyone who has made this such a wonderful experience, thank you from the bottom of my heart. And hopefully my family, thank you for being patient with me, and hopefully this will make you less mad of all the trains that I've missed coming home. And audience, thank you so much for being here. One more thing. Excuse me, one moment.
River running free, and oh, how I feel. sure to come next week for the solo and recital, small ensemble recital. Get home safely. Thank you again.